Hello everybody, welcome back to my tutorial series on WooCommerce discounts. In this video, we're going to learn what is a sale badge and how to customize the sale badge. Alright? Well, we're going to use the popular WooCommerce discount plugin called Discount Rules Pro for WooCommerce to create such discounts. Before we get into the video, please make sure you have downloaded, installed and activated the Discount Rules Pro plugin on your site. If you haven't done this yet, then please do not worry because we have a video that can help you to install the Discount Rules plugin which we have posted already. You can find the link to download the plugin as well as the tutorial video in the description below. Feel free to check the description below for further details. With that being said, let's get started. Sale badge is nothing but an indication to customers that a specific product is on sale or has discounts. Alright, so these sale badges are there by default in WooCommerce itself. But if you want to also show sale tags on products having discounts coming from the WooDiscount Rules plugin, you can also do that by enabling it. Alright, so the sale tag looks something like this. So these indicates that products are on sale. Alright, so let us see how to enable this and customize it according to our needs using the WooDiscount Rules plugin. For this, we'll have to go to the WordPress dashboard. Under WooCommerce, you'll be able to find WooDiscount Rules, and if you click on Add New Rule, you will be able to create your rules. I have already created a rule. Let me click on this Edit option and show you what I've created. Alright, so you can notice that I have a discount based on a category. So the category that receives the discount is accessories. Alright, so all products under accessories category receives a 20% off. Okay. Now if you want to show sale badge on all products under this accessories category, you can do so by enabling it from the settings. Let's go to the settings, and under the product settings, the very first thing you'll notice is the on sale badge. So if you have enabled the on sale badge here, you will be able to show it on products that are having discount price coming from the Discount Rules plugin. Alright, you can notice, let me take you to the accessories page, the category page. You can notice that all products under accessories category is eligible for discount, and that we know using the sale badge, isn't it? Amazing. Let me also show you the different options while enabling the sale badge. Now if you notice, I have opted for the option show on products that are covered under any discount rule. So no matter how many rules we have in our plugin, if you want to show sale badge on products that are covered under any discount rule, then you can go for this specific option. Now if you want the sale badge to be appeared on the products only after the rule condition is matched, then you can go for show only after a rule condition is matched. So if you select this first option, which is show only after a rule condition is matched, when you visit the shop page, it won't show. Means the sale badge will not be visible. What happens is only if you add it to the cart or if the condition is matched in the cart, then the particular product will receive a sale tag. Alright, so that is the function of the show only after a rule condition is matched exactly. Right? And the third option is do not show. If you do not want the sale badge, then you can turn this off. Alright, so these are the different options. According to your requirements, you can select one that is helpful. Alright, the next thing is, you can also customize the sale badge, and if you're looking for ways to customize the sale badge, then here are a few settings that could help. The first one is an option for you to confirm if you would like to customize the sale badge. So if you would like to customize it, you can click on this checkbox. Second one is useful for override. What happens is, especially when you have theme and the theme has override for sale badge, then you can just click on this option which forces override this label for the sale badge. Alright, and the third option is quite an interesting one. If you want to provide, if you would like to display the percentage or the discount value in the sale badge, then you can do so. For this accessories category, I have created a 20% off. Alright, so if you want the sale tag to display 20% inside it instead of the sale label, you can also do that. So if you want to do that, you will have to click on this checkbox. Alright. Now before I show you the output for the percentage and sale badge, here are a few things you need to notice. The first one is sale badge content. So if you want to edit this content, This is there by default. By default, whenever a product has a sale coming from discount tools plugin or from WooCommerce, the sale tag will be displayed. Alright, so if you want to edit the label to something else, then you can actually edit the sale batch content. But please make sure that you only do it if you are very sure and confident with HTML. Alright, nice. And this, whatever changes you make here will be applicable for products having discounts coming from the discount rules plugin only. Alright, so it will take effect on the products having discount price coming from the discount rules plugin. The next thing is sale batch percentage content. As said, just like the sale batch content, even the percentage content can be edited only if you're very sure about HTML. Alright, and these also affect the products that are only having discounts coming from the discount rules plugin. With that said, let's save the settings and see if we are able to display a percentage inside the sale batch. Well, here we go. We have saved the settings now. Let me refresh this page and show you that a 20% is displayed inside the sale batch, isn't it? So this is how we enable sale batch and customize them. And this is a wonderful way to indicate customers that products are on sale. Thank you so much for watching.